Hello, I'm Arit, Assistant Professor of Gargi Memorial Institute of Technology. In our today's lecture, we try to understand the how Ruby laser is work. In our previous lecture, we already know about the what is the mechanism of the laser, how it is work, how the atom is transits from one energy level to another energy level, and those characteristics. And now we are study about some example of the laser. In our last lecture, we try to understand the what is how the helium neon laser is work. In this lecture, we try to understand the how the Ruby laser is work. What is Ruby laser? The main part of the Ruby laser is main parts is working material is a ruby crystal. Okay. Exciting system, which source is exciting this whole system is helical xenon flash tube. Okay, and another we have a cooling system. Okay. It is done by the water circulating. Okay, this is the main structure of the Ruby laser. This is a glass tube. This is the Ruby material. Okay, where this one is a fully reflecting end phase. Okay, and this one is partially reflecting phase, and this is the obviously Ruby rod. What is Ruby? I will explain you. This spiral one is a power source. Okay, the emitting laser beam. Okay, and those two are the cooling system. The water is circulating in the whole system is in it through this one and out through this one. Okay, this is the cooling system. Okay, now what is Ruby? Ruby is nothing but a Al2O3 Cr2O3. The aluminium oxide, aluminium oxide, Al2O3, which in the aluminium oxide, some aluminium atom are replaced by chromium atom. Cr2 O3, this acting medium, this whole active medium is known as the ruby material. Okay, so what is that? In an aluminium oxide, some aluminium atom is if replaced by the chromium oxide, then the material is known as ruby. Okay, so in this active material, so we are now studying about the what is construction of the ruby laser. Okay, this active medium in this active medium, the active material is active medium, the active material is Cr3+, because the chromium, some aluminium is replaced by the chromium, and it is so this chromium atom is now ionized due to this external power source. When you put some external power in through the system, due to this external energy, the material is ionized, and the active ion is known as chromium ion. Okay, chromium 3+ ion. Okay, so the standardized way, the ruby, the rod, the length of the rod is the standard length of the rod is 4 cm, and diameter is 0.5 cm, and it is parallel to the tube and polished. This rod must be parallel to the tube, and it is must be polished, and the diameter must be 0.5 cm, and the length of the rod must be 4 cm, is the standard version of the loose ruby laser. Okay, it is vary with the different type of tube. Okay, now the ruby rod is surrounded by a helical, I have already mentioned this name, helical xenon flash tube. Okay, this tube is known as helical xenon flash tube, which is provided the pumping light to rise the chromium ion to the upper energy state. So that means this tube is responsible for the chromium ion to the jump from initial lower energy state to the upper energy state. Is it clear? So this ruby rod, tube is known as helical xenon flash tube, which provide the pumping light. So that means the external energy, the pumping energy, is done by this tube. Due to this energy, the chromium ion in between this rod is jumped from lower energy state to the higher energy state. and in a microsecond, in microsecond, that this tube consumes several thousand joule of energy. So that means the external, this spiral where provide the energy, and the tube is observe that energy, and the consumption rate of this tube is, it is, this tube can consume in millisecond several thousand of joule energy. On the other part, the energy, this energy used for the chromium to excite that chromium atom in the ruby material and jump to lower energy state to upper energy state. That means this spiral provides some energy to the tube, and the tube provides the tube absorbs that energy, and this energy is responsible for the chromium atom. So which chromium is active material in this material, because this chromium atom is ionized right now, Cr3+. This chromium atom is now get the energy through this tube and jump from lower energy state to upper energy state. This is the basic mechanism of the ruby laser. Now, how it is working in a transition level? How it is working in a transition level? Let draw a diagram of the transition level. So this one is E1, this one is E3, this one is E2. Atom jump from first state to second state, this second state to third state, first state. So this one is a metastable state. Excited, this one is an excited state. Ground level. Okay, pumping, transition. This is the first step, this is the second step, this is the third step, and this one is the fourth step. And this transition is known as radiation. And this is the laser transition. So, through this diagram, we can see that there is a three energy state, E1, E2, and E2 and E3 represent the energy level of the chromium ion. Because now the chromium, the activated ion in the ruby material is chromium 3+, Cr3+. Now this ion is in a ground state. This chromium atom can jump from ground state to say metastable state or excited state. So there is a, we divided the energy level in a three state. Okay, the chromium ion is in a ground state. Energy level is E1. Due to the external energy of this spiral wire provides some energy to this xenon flash, this glass tube. Now this glass tube, this energy is absorbed by the glass tube, and the chromium atom is now excited. When the tube is charged up, this energy is gotten by the non-active chromium atom, and now this atom is get the energy, and this atom is now activated. This ions is now activated and jump from ground state energy to the excited state. That means E1 to E3, and it is providing from the outside pumping transition. Suppose the wavelength of the standard pumping wavelength is almost 5500 angstrom. Okay, now the atom is now in a excited state. For the first step is done, E1 to E2, now atom is in a excited state. the transition of the one optical pumping. This is by, done by the optical pumping, because we provide the energy by through the flash tube, and flash tube provides some light through the ruby laser. Okay, to the ruby laser. Actually, this spiral is providing some light, and this flash tube absorb that light and give it to the ruby rod, and the chromium, active chromium ions get the energy and jump to the excited state. So this is the optical pumping. This pumping is not only normal pumping, is also known as a optical pumping. In the last helium neon laser, we already know that in that case we use the electric discharge pumping, but in the ruby laser we use the optical pumping. We provide some light from the outside. Okay. Now in the transition two, these ions is jump from energy state E3 to E2, and this energy is not a light energy. The radiate energy when the ions is jump from the excited state to the metastable state, the extra energy released from this jump, this energy is not a laser energy. This is known as a radiation transition. That means in this transition we cannot get any type of light beam or wave. Okay. Thus the number of atoms in the state of E2 goes increasing when you provide the optical pumping. Due to this optical energy, the number of ions is jumped to the excited state, and for the instability, this atoms is now is in a metastable state. So in a metastable state, so that means the number of ions in the E2 state is now increasing. That means in this process we get the population inversion. Okay. The number of ion in the ground state is now decreasing. So that means when the total number of atom in the ground state, whole number of active chromium atom now jump to the E3 state, and then for the instability, that whole number of atoms now jump to in a metastable state. Then they are now steady in this metastable state. That means the ground state level is now become decreasing. The number of atom is now is much lesser than the metastable state. So right now, due to the spontaneous transition is very high, because the number of atoms in that stage is very much high. Okay, so very much high due to the, now the third state is E2 to E1. It is done by the spontaneous emission. Due to the spontaneous emission, some laser beam is, the light wave is released. It is also is known as a laser beam. And due to this laser beam, So some laser beam is released. Now this laser beam is traveling through this rod. Okay. Due to this spontaneous emission. Suppose this laser beam is traveling through this rod. Due to this optic fully reflecting end of phase. Due to this fully reflecting phase, these photons is reflected from the surface and again return to this direction. When this laser beam return to its direction, this laser beam is now excited the rest of the atom in the metastable state, and due to this process, the another transition is happened, the fourth transition. It is also E2 to E1. It is done by the stimulated emission. And we get the high intense light after this process. So again, remind this, due to this external energy by the xenon, helical xenon tube observe the optical beam, it is provide some energy to the ruby dot. In this ruby dot, the chromium atoms, active chromium atoms, get the energy and jump to the E1 state to E2 state. Okay? E1 state to E2 state. Now for the instability, these atoms now is coming over to the metastable state, and this transition is known as radiation transition. You cannot get any type of light wave. Okay, now the number of atoms in the metastable state, the number of atoms or ions in the metastable state is now increasing compared to the ground state energy level. So that means for the heavy number of atoms in a metastable state, the atoms jump from E2 to E1. This is a spontaneous emission. Due to this spontaneous emission, we get some laser beam. Now this laser beam is traveling through this ruby rod. So, and reflected from the one surface. This is a partially reflecting surface. And when this beam is traveling through this rod, this laser beam is excited the rest of the atoms or ions in the metastable state. Due to the excitation, this rest of the atoms now jumps from E2 to E1. It is done by the stimulated emission, because we gave the energy through this laser, and we get a high intense laser beam. This is the working formula of the laser beam. Then the output of this laser beam is 6,943 angstrom. This is the resultant wavelength of the ruby laser. And the power, the wavelength is 6,943 angstrom. Power of this laser is 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 6 watt. So it is a very high voltage, high power ruby laser. Obviously its active medium is a ruby rod, and the type of this laser is 3 level laser. Because we use the three, we can see that there is, due to this transition of this beam, there is a three level of energy state. So this type of laser is known as three level laser. It is done by the optical pumping. The helical xenon flash tube is responsible for optical pumping, and the frequency of this laser, (4.32 × 10⁴ Hz. Okay, and what is the advantage of disadvantage of this laser beam? This is monochromatic. In this laser, the thermal distortion is very much higher. That's why you need a cooling system. Okay, and another thing is that the application of the ruby laser, it is used in a laboratory experiment. So, it is used by the drilling of the bilateral materials. It is also used in a interferometer holography in a optics. It is also used in a light detection and light ranging. It is also used in a treatment of the detached retina. Okay. So this is the end of this lecture. So in this lecture we just study about the how, what is ruby laser and how it is work and what is the application of the ruby laser. All things are is in my PDF notes. Please go through this and go through this. In the next lecture we try to understand the another laser, and in the second next lecture we try to solve the mathematical problem of the laser related problems. Okay, thank you.